Teachers, manpower analysis and projection. How do we project manpower or teachers' requirement in a school? Now we look at the attrition and retention rate of teachers. Two things are bound to happen: the rate at which teachers leave the school and the rate at which they are able to be retained within the school. There are factors that are responsible for this. One of such factors is withdrawal of service. Some teachers may decide to withdraw their service. Probably they have a better service elsewhere. They withdraw their service and join another service. Another thing is resignation. Some teachers may decide to resign totally from the system and do some other things which is known to them. And another is dismissal. Sometimes it is the employer that may wish to dismiss the teacher. And when this happened also, it affects the availability of teachers that are in the school. They will have the debt. Debt can occur. It is something that we don't have control over. As human, it can come up anytime. Now we have retirement. The retirement usually come up after you have spent the number of years required by law in service. And when this happens, you are bound to leave and equally affect the number of teachers that left. Now, how do we calculate the teachers' retention rate? To calculate teachers' retention rate, you have a formula that will help us to do that. Here is the formula. You have T raised to power T small t, and you have the R at the bottom equals T raised to power T plus 1 plus R raised to power T plus 1 over T raised to power T times 100, where T raised to power T and R represent teachers' retention rate in year T. This year T means the base year, the beginning year. Then we'll have the stock of teachers in year T, that is the number of teachers that you have at the time that that base year. Then you have T plus 1. This means stock of teachers in year T plus 1 the following year. For example, if year T is 2000, year T plus 1 will be 2001. Then here we have the number N raised to power T plus 1, the number of teachers entering the service in year T plus 1. In this case, like the example, say 2001. If year T, the base year is 2000, year T plus 1 will be 2001. If year T, the base year is 1999, year T plus 1 will be 2000, and so on. If this is 2017, year T plus 1 will be 2018. So year T plus 1 is the following year. Now let's look at some example here. Here we have an example. If there were 100,000 teachers in the teaching stock of a state in 2000, remember this 2000, because the first year we are mentioning is the base year, that is year T. And there were 103,000 teachers in 2003, that is year T plus 1 the following year. And 8,000 new teachers employed in year 2003, that is the same year T plus 1. We can calculate the teachers' retention rate in 2002. Because somebody will ask you, what is the teacher retention rate in 2002? This can be calculated. How do you do this? Now bring in the formula. In bringing in the formula, remember we have this, which is the following year, year T the following year. What is it here? That is our 103,000 teachers minus the N plus T in the following year. Remember, new teachers were employed and there were 8,000 teachers. Over 100,000 teachers times 100, and that will give you 95,000 over 100,000 times 100, and that will give us 95% or 0.95%. Now you come up, what does it imply? This implies that the system ability to retain teachers is 95%, which is high, but however it can be improved upon. On the other hand, you see that the teachers attrition or wastage rate is measured by the extent at which teachers have the teachers leave a school system. Because remember, you would have spent some money on these teachers in a school to train them, to upgrade. So if they leave, it becomes a wastage to that school. How do you determine this? You have T raised to power TW, represent teacher wastage rate in year T. So here you say 1 minus that T, the subscript and the superscript T and R. So what would this imply if we have to use this example here that we have? That we means 1 minus 0.95. Remember, we have 0.95 here and we have 95%. Whichever way we work it, that will give us 5%. On the other hand, the 5% will represent 5,000 of 100,000 teachers. So if we say 5,000, which is the 5,000 over 100,000 teachers times 100, that will give us 5%. So what does this mean? It means that out of the 100 teachers in the previous year, out of this 100 teachers in the previous year, 5,000 of them left the system at the end of the previous year. It was the 800 newly employed that added up to the 95 that were left that made up 103,000 teachers. Then this implies that the teacher attrition, if you now look at the teacher attrition rate, is 5%. That means the rate at which teachers leave the system is 5%.